At first, those vital talks in Geneva, and Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Khamenei, who weighed in again, saying that his country would not give up its nuclear rights. Now, Mark Fitzpatrick has a unique perspective on these talks, having served as the U.S. Deputy Assistant Secretary for Non-Proliferation, and he joins me now live from Rome. Welcome, Mr. Fitzpatrick.
Happy to be here, Christian.
Thanks for joining me. Let me first ask you, you've seen the to and fro between Israel and the United States over this vital issue of a deal between Iran and the rest of the world. Do you then think, given your perspective, that it is possible to reach a deal?
I think it is possible. I'm unusually optimistic that all the pieces are in place for a deal. It's only an interim deal for 6 months. It won't solve the problems that either side has, but it will be enough to cap the program and to build some confidence toward a longer-term settlement.
In regards to the West getting absolute surety that there will not be a military program, do you think that this is a time when they can get that assurance? Because clearly that is what people worry about in Israel, even in the United States. Is that something that, that can actually, that confidence be built up?
Well, I don't think that any degree of verification can provide 100% assurance that Iran won't be able to build a nuclear weapon secretly. But what this interim deal will do will be to double the time that it would take Iran to make a dash for it. Now, how long would it take Iran to make a dash for a nuclear weapon? I think it would take near to a year. But some calculations are shorter than that. A strictly mathematical calculation that doesn't take into account all the practical difficulties. Some of them would say that maybe a month and a half to the time where Iran would be able to produce enough highly enriched uranium for one nuclear weapon. This deal would at least double that time, and it would all be verified. So in that sense, yes, Iran's ability to produce a nuclear weapon will be more restricted than is the case today.
What about the idea of the Arak plutonium plant, the heavy water reactor, which everybody is concerned about, and some say that is something that Israel might decide to, you know, take out that plant if it looks like it's going to properly come online and fuel be introduced. Does Iran need to verifiably simply suspend operations there, stop operations?
Well, the Arak reactor has become a new factor in these talks, because it could produce a plutonium route to nuclear weapons, a route that would take a couple of years for Iran to be able to put in place. But the concern is that once the reactor goes online, which might happen maybe a year or more, that it becomes invulnerable, because nobody would want to attack it and spew radiation into the atmosphere once it goes online. So there's a dynamic in place here that says, look, you've got to stop the construction of the reactor. I don't know if Iran's going to go for that. That's one of the key issues that will be discussed in Geneva in these talks. But yes, will that be monitored if they stop the construction? They would have to agree to additional monitoring beyond that which the International Atomic Energy Agency today is carrying out.
And finally, Israel and many of the conservatives in the United States would like to see Iran fully get out of the business of enrichment. Ayatollah Khamenei has said, and the negotiators have said, that that is our red line. We insist on that right. Is it even a starter that you think Iran would give up enrichment altogether?
You know, it would be ideal if Iran would give up enrichment, and it's called for in numerous Security Council resolutions that it suspend enrichment. But anybody who knows anything about Iran knows that that's an impossibility. Iran is just simply not going to capitulate, no matter how many sanctions they face. They're not going to knuckle under. There's going to be some enrichment at the end of the day of any deal that's done. That's as clear as day. And the question is, how much enrichment? How carefully will it be monitored? What will be the time that it would take Iran to build a nuclear weapon if they decided to go for broke? And the whole point of the negotiations is to try to extend that timeline beyond the maybe 1.5 months to get the fissile material to 3-6 more months. I think the negotiators are going to be able to pull a deal off that will give America enough time.
Mark Fitzpatrick, thank you very much for joining me from Rome.
Happy to talk to you, Christian. Thank you.